So this is a complete kit for the product, handheld vascular Doppler, model VD8M. You can also see the serial number of the product. So this product is for measuring the ankle brachial index. So this complete kit is supplied in a padded high quality bag, which can be carried by any transport services. Now let's see the number of items available in this package. So you will see different small items. So you have the Doppler VD item. This is the main Doppler, and this is the transducer, 8 MHz transducer. And then we have a charger. This is a charger you can just connect it to the wall socket. And then you have, there's a provision for 4 batteries. We supply 2 batteries because we need 2 batteries for running the product. If you need, you can also put 2 more batteries and you can charge it, and you can have them as a standby batteries. And you will also have the ultrasound gel, because Doppler will not travel through air, it needs some coupling media. So this is ultrasound gel coming along with this. So these gels can be purchased from us later on if you need. We have different sizes. We have 5 liter, we have 250 ml, we have 60 grams. You can select depending upon your need. We also supply sphygmomanometer dial type for measuring the blood pressure, for calculating ABI. And then we have a detailed manual, user manual. It describes about the ABI, how to measure ABI, then different parts, all the information available. We also give a CD. It comes with a complementary software for calculating ABI. So the ABI software will, you can add up your header, hospital header, patient details, doctor name, and then once you enter the pressure values, it gives you the ABI index. Then you can get a colorful print from this. This CD also has a video demonstration of the whole product. You can watch the video and then see how the ABI is being measured, how the Doppler controls are explained, and everything about the products are there within that CD. While the ABI is done, the patient has to be in supine position. The blood pressure cuff is tied onto the brachial, on the right side brachial, and the manometer is fixed properly. Now we are ready for the testing. Ultrasound will not pass through air, and hence apply liberal amount of ultrasound jelly. Normal arterial sound will be multiphasic. You can see the multiphasic sound, you will have more than one sound. Now you will be listening to the venous sound, which is continuous in sound. There is no pulsatile sound. Now the blood pressure cuff is inflated, about 20 mm Hg pressure on the systolic, and then slowly deflated, and when the first sound, which is now about 140 mm Hg, he is getting the first sound, that is the systolic pressure. Now the blood pressure cuff is tied at the ankle, and apply jelly. Then the probe is kept at posterior tibial. Please check the probe. So probe angle, it is facing the blood flow. So you'll be getting the good sound. After getting the good sound, then we have to inflate the cuff without losing the track. Inflate it above the systole. Preferably be 20 mm above the systole. The sound stops and slowly deflate. When the first sound reappears, that's the ankle systolic. Now we are getting somewhere around 142.
So 142 is the systolic pressure at posterior tibial. Note it down. Apply jelly at dorsalis pedis. See the position of the probe. Gently touch it. Pick up good sound. Don't lose track. Then inflate the cuff. Same way. Sound stops and slowly deflate. When the first sound reappears, take the pressure. It's about 140. So 140 is the systolic pressure at dorsalis pedis. Please note it down. Now tie the cuff on the left brachial. Apply gel. Switch on the machine and check for the arterial sound. Pick up good sound. Look at the angle. It's about 45 degrees. Once you pick up the good sound, then you inflate above the system. The sound stops. Slowly deflate. When the first sound reappears, take down the pressure. That is systolic pressure. For this patient, we are getting somewhere around 132. Take down the pressure. Tie the cuff at ankle. Look at the position of the BP cuff. Apply gel. Switch on the machine. Pick up the sound. Look at the angle. Once you get the good sound, then inflate it till the sound stops. Slowly deflate. At one point the sound will reappear. Take the pressure. It's about 142. 142 is the posterior tip. Without changing the cups, keep the probe at dorsalis pedis. Pick up the sound and then inflate. Slowly deflate and first sound reappears, no down. It's about 132 for this particular patient. This completes ABI. We have seen how the ABI is being measured. Now to calculate the ankle brachial index, we need to have the highest of systolic pressure and the posterior tibial of each foot divided by the highest of left and right brachial pressure. So that index is nothing but the ankle brachial index. For this particular patient, we have measured, these are the different values. So based on the value, highest of the right and left is 140. For the left side, 142 by 140, 142 is the highest. And the right side, 140 is the highest. And then the ABA is, as per this, is 1.01 and 0.98. So the normal reference value as per TOS 2 guidelines is normally is 0.91 to 1.4, mild is 0.7 to 0.9, and moderate is 0.4 to 0.69, and less than 0.4 is severe, and when more than 1.4 indicates incompressible artery. Every Doppler machine comes with a software CD. You can place the CD inside your computer tray and install the software as per the instructions. Once the software is installed, this ABA calculator icon is generated. So once you generate this icon, then you can able to record the ABA values and then take a printout. So I am clicking it. Yes. I get the main screen. This is the main screen for ABA calculator. There are few controls here. You can see settings, auto ID, preview, reset, and exit. I select settings. So once I select settings, then I get this screen. This screen is for the header. So I can create a letterhead for the hospital here. So I can edit it, I can delete it, I can change it, I can change the font, I can change it to different fonts, whatever fonts, either totally or line by line. I can change it. Now I am changing it to some different font. I can change the color. So now I change the color. This looks very small. So I change this. And this is 2. Okay, I will give 1 line space. And then I can change the color. I'll change it to black. Okay, some dark color. Now it's ready. And you can change the consultant name. You can type in, you can erase it, and you can type specialization, you can type and change it. Examiner, that means the technician name, you can add it. You can also set logo. If you have a logo, either in BMP file format or JPG file format, then you can also bring in the logo inside the header. Now I have our logo in this, so I'll just have a preview. This is how your letterhead would look like. So you will get a line, and then on top of that, whatever you want, you can add. You have the logo, you have the hospital name, you can add your phone number, email, everything you can add. But whatever you add, it should be within these 2 lines. Now everything is ready. I just say save and exit. I'm coming to the main screen. This is patient ID. Some institutions have their own unique ID for every patient. In such case, you can type in the patient ID. There are some institutions, they don't follow any ID. For them, you can just say auto ID. Then the computer generates an ID for them. Then you can select the patient name, the gender, and then age, the consultant, all the details will be there. Now you go to the box. Now if you remember the patient, then his blood pressure for the right side is 140 and the left side is 132, and the posterior tibial right side is 142, left side it was 140, and this side it is 140, and then this is 132, I think. And then once you select, then you get 1.01 and 1. How it is calculated? It is taking highest of the brachial, so 140 is the highest. Okay, for the right side, highest of this 142 and 140 the highest, so 142 divided by 140. So that's the ABA for the right side, 1.01. If you see here, it is 140. Here it is 132. So 140 divided by the highest of this 140, so which is equal to 1. So this is the ABA. So as per this, it says automatically normal right arterial study, normal left arterial study. So these are the task 2 guidelines value, and as per this, you will get it. To print it, go to preview. Your report is generated. So here the logo, hospital name, patient details, the brachial pressures, and then you get the posterior tibial, dorsal SPDs, AB index, TAS2 guidelines, the interpretation, the consultant name. So you just say print, and then if the printer is connected, you will get the print. So that's it. So we have completed the patient. So I just say exit. It's done. So these are the people who are at risk for the peripheral arterial disease. So you can see, it's a self-explanatory, you can see all the risk factors. Thank you for watching this video. This completes a complete measurement of ABA, nothing but the ankle brachial index. We sincerely thank you for spending your valuable time. and understanding these ankle brachial index measurements. Thank you once again.